Alright guys, PUBG. So before we start working on this particular PUBG competition, let's talk about some resources that you require if you want to work along with me. So before that, let's directly go to Kaggle. By the way, I'm already on Kaggle. And if you're new to Kaggle, you have to sign up to participate in any competition using your Gmail or some other account. So here we are in a PUBG. Let's directly go to PUBG. And as you can see, around 1200 team participate in this competition. So it's a pretty famous one. So here we are in a PUBG competition, and let's directly go to data. Here, let's go down, and here we are. Here the train and test data set, and as you can see, the training data set consists of around 4.45 million rows, while the test one consists around 2 million rows, which is really huge. If you have a normal system, it's kind of impossible task to work with that huge size of data. So how do we gonna do that? I don't have a GPU, and probably you don't have a GPU, that's why you're watching me. So how do we handle that huge size of data? One thing could, you can use cloud services like Google Colab, AWS or Azure and some other. But if you directly start working on these cloud services for these competitions, it's really gonna put a lot much burden on your wallet. So stay tuned with us, because here I'm gonna talk about few tricks and trips through which you can save you a lot much money. So how do we handle that huge size of data set? And for that, I'm going to use a Google free cloud service called Google Colab. Yes, you hear me right. It's free cloud service from Google, and that offers the power of GPU and TPU for you. So let's directly go to Google Colab, and Google Colab. Here we are in a Google Colab, and let's go. And to start working on Google Colab, you need a basic thing is Gmail account. With a Gmail account, you're ready to work on it. So let's cancel it out. And from here, directly go to file and choose your working background, whether you like to work with Python 3 or Python 2. I like to work with Python 3, so I'll choose Python 3. It's gonna take some time, so let's talk about this. And as you can see here, right now, I already signed up using my Gmail account. So be ready and sign up to Google Colab using your Gmail account. I think it's done, not yet. It's gonna take some time, probably because of internet connection. Yes, so here we go, ready. So as at the top, you can see it named as an untitled IPython notebook. You can even change to yours one like practice IPython notebook. And in the cell here, you can see you're going to put all your code in that cell. And it's worked pretty similar the way Jupyter notebook work. So if you like write down some kind of code in these cells and say, hello, okay, let's run it. And very first time, it's going to take some time because it took some time to initialize it. And it prints hello. All the things work pretty similar as a Jupyter notebook. And now few of you guys must be thinking, again we have to go through that hassle of installing so many Python libraries. For that I say you are lucky, my friend, because Google pre-installed all these libraries for you. Like if you want to import pandas, you can import directly pandas, and let's run it. See, it's gonna import pandas. Same for NumPy, it's gonna import NumPy. All the libraries are pre-installed in that particular Google Colab notebook. And if you like to check what are these libraries or framework, so simply say pip freeze and run it. It's gonna output all the libraries that are pre-installed in that Google Colab notebook. Here you can see, oh my god, look at the libraries, look at the set of libraries. It's like it's a treasure hunt. You get everything doing nothing. See, libraries, framework, even Flask, Jupyter Notebook, and Django, even installing that. So it's everything is over here right now. You don't need to install so many things externally. But in case if you have to install some other library, you can even install it using pip command. Say exclamation pip, and let's say pandas. The way I do pandas, you can do for others. So run it, it will install that particular library in your Google Colab notebook. See, it's already done because library is already present. Now let's talk about one important thing about this Google Colab notebook. How do we import data from a local machine to this Google Colab? For that, we're gonna say from google.colab import files, and then say upload. This is gonna create a background or a face through which you can upload data from your desktop or some other files. Choose a file and it will direct you to a local machine. From there, you can choose a folder or file that you want to work on your Google Colab. Now let's cancel it out from here because we don't have to import any files right now. We're gonna use it in future video. And the last and most important thing, how to avail the computational power of GPU or TPU, because that's what's gonna make us to work on that huge size of data set on Google Colab. For that, you directly go to edit, and in that edit section, you can look for notebook and settings. And here you can see hardware accelerator, click that. And here you can see GPU and TPU. For GPU, Google provide Tesla K80, which is pretty powerful. And TPU that Google recently added to this Google Colab. So I'm gonna go for GPU, you can choose yours one. So let's save it. And here we go. We have the computational power of GPU, and now we are ready to work with that huge size of data set. So in general, it's the basic thing that you require if you want to work along with me on that PUBG competition. So we prepare with that because we're gonna use Google Colab a lot. And as always, thanks for watching. Thanks for all your support and subscription. See you in the next video.